as I document my journey, I think I need to take some time to talk about my issues. My issue has not been weight training. Since I've got consistency, since January 2017, man, slaying some weights, man. I'm not a cardio king. I don't really like doing cardio, but I can jump rope forever. I can walk for miles. No problem. I've gotten used to it. Sometimes I do long, drawn out workouts. Sometimes I will do little baby workouts, as I call them, because I'm going to do something. So I might just do 100 jumping jacks, and that's my workout for the day. So the consistency in the gym had been a problem. Sometimes I get a little caught up, and I don't always switch up like I should. I track my workouts, track y'all workouts, y'all. I use Fit Notes. Also, there's a good app called, I think it's called JE Fit. I don't know how to say it, JE Fit. You got body space. When you know, pen and paper is good, but you can lose pen and paper, you know. But to have that app on your phone to keep a record, to give you graphs, charts, set goals, it's really cool. Anyway, so the working out part, I've been able to do that. The food, man. It's the food. I put a post, somebody said, what has helped you, kept you from reaching your goals? I think that because I lift hard, I can eat whatever I want. And don't get me wrong, I do not eat that horribly bad, especially compared to what I used to eat. But for me and my body, I can't eat like a normal person. Like, I don't know how to say it. Like, you know, I can track my calories and they can say I burnt 1,000 calories. My recommended calories is 2,000. I ate 2,500. But if those 500 or something calorie, it's the wrong stuff, like honey buns and pizza and burgers, my body don't like that, man. It's like, why are you doing this to me? But it I guess it liked the fat because it seemed to hold on to it, you know? So it's like, I'm going to be accountable. For January 2017, I said I'm going to post about this journey. So many times I say, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. And I'm not going to say my diet is going to be 100% clean. I'm not going back to gluten-free, soy-free, peanut-free, dairy-free, low-sugar, sugar-free right now. But I can't stop, you know, getting cocky and saying, oh, I'm lifting hard. I deserve this donut. No, I don't, because my stomach don't look the way it should be. And if I'm going to be in the fitness business, I'm going to help transform life. I probably need to focus as well on transforming my life, dropping about 10% body fat so I can look better, not just for me, not just for clients, but for my wife as well. And also, you know, you don't need to, this for everybody. Healthy is good. I see a lot of things say thick and fit, that's fine. And also, but you also gotta remember that obesity, having too much fat, cause your organs to work harder than they should be. That can lead to diseases. You could die an early death. Well, even if you live in that fit life, if you're not doing what you can, I'm talking to you, Walter, I'm talking to you directly. If you're not doing what you can to make sure that you got your diet on point as well, make those sacrifices with the fort like you make in the weight room, then you're just hurting yourself. And I'm done hurting myself. So that's it. I'm going to put this on my YouTube page, Facebook page, Instagram page. Just like I said I would in January 2017 when I said I would no longer be a has-been. And there you go. I don't have a specific weight that I'm trying to get to, but I do need to drop some fat. So if I'm 250 pounds and I've dropped some fat, oh, hey, yeah, that's sexy, baby. But if I'm 250 pounds and I'm still carrying around this gut, unacceptable. Unacceptable. So y'all can reach out to me, give me your feedback, thoughts, comments, well wishes, whatever it is. Bonzilla out.